Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. And tonight I'm doing this. I decided I'm going to take DR-102, aka Rick, for a drive on the North York Moors because I don't think I've actually driven him properly on the North York Moors yet. So that's what I'm going to do, and I'm going to only put a few little linky pops around. Because, yeah, I'm not going to post it on my groups and things. Because, you know what, I'm like, I'll do a stream and then I'll immediately think, oh, crumbs, I don't like this. So, yeah. I'll probably jump into one of my voice chats soon. If people are around, of course. I think my link works and my group. Let me just have a look. And, yes, it does. Good. So, again, I'm going to start from Pickering. And I'm going to be driving up to Grosmont and Goathland. Well, Grosmont is the first I'll go, and then I'll run round and I'll go the other way. Yeah, this is a bit sudden, by the way. I will be checking the chat periodically and looking to see whether anybody loves me or not. I don't think they do, to be quite honest. So, on that note, let me just get some sound adjustments done, and then I think I can get started. So, let's see, open my sound. Oh, no, not that, you idiot. Person, I want my volume mixer, thank you very much, because, yeah, now, if I just move the sound down a bit, can everyone hear me alright over Rick's incessant noise? I hope they can. I also need to set myself a path, because the way I'm doing this is I haven't bothered setting a path because I want to run around at the other end, so I'm hoping that it's just going to go smoothly. I'm just going to zoom up the route. So this is the North York Moors Railway, but it's known as the Whitby and Pickering Heritage, I think. And it's on SSS, I think, Steam Sound Supreme. This is just me doing preamble before we get going. I'm pretty sure Rick's going to start blowing off any moment now, because we still haven't really worked out how to stop that happening. There we go. See, look at that. I predicted that. I think the only real way to stop that happening is to drive him first. I'm going to have to check that later, I think. So anyway, yeah, I hope the sound settings were okay. Yeah, I hope it looks alright. And yeah, I'm hoping to sort out some more. Someone just mentioned about the driver experience course I did with Edward Bull a little while ago. I'm hoping to set some more of those up soon, actually, because I kind of like doing them. So if any patrons are watching tonight, or any patrons in general want to have a go, you have to, like, nominally you have to be a $5 or above patron, but usually I'll let $1 patrons have a go if they're regular on voice chats and things, so bear that in mind. So you might notice something odd about DR-102 once we get started. He is in the configuration he would be when he goes out and visits other railways, because other railways can't really accommodate his ridiculous length, so we have to compromise and run him with the ROD tender when he goes off on his hollybobs, as you say. So I'll probably have someone else in front chat me in a little while, I think. But we shall see. Anyway, if people are happy for me to start, I guess we'll get rocking and rolling. For people asking how I am, I'm fine. I'll talk a little bit more about my personal things in a moment. But without further ado, shall we go on our little hollybob with Rick? So here we go. I don't know whether the in-game sounds are a little bit quiet, but he's blown off at the moment, so. We'll need to blow off some steam. And I'll try and stick to a decent speed limit. I'm not going to be going, like, romping at a million miles an hour with him. I think I want to get a different angle, actually, if we leave. But, yeah, you'll notice as Rick comes round the corner, if I can get out of some trees, that he looks a bit different, because he looks a lot different with an ROD tender, because he looks a lot, I would say 2800-ish. I've got a lovely rake of Matrix Train / Gordon Mack LNER teaks, because that's what they do. By the way, I'll also be investing in a second monitor soon, so I'll be able to actually watch the YouTube chats and be able to actually respond a little bit better, because at the moment I have to keep sort of switching between, you know, between the actual full screen TS and then going and jumping into YouTube. I don't know why I keep clapping my hands at the moment. I keep clapping my hands as if it means something. Man, look at all this foliage. Look at that. I'm not even protected in the cab. Ah! It's just everything flying through my engine. Ah, fiddly johnnies. Ah! Jeez. You can tell I've been watching Kadikaris recently. Another level crossing. I do like level crossings. I should build more. Maybe. Someone asked me joining us tonight. I think Oliver. I was going to join the Patreon lounge, but I know what will happen. Besides, I'm waiting for Oliver to turn up. Whenever Oliver turns up in one of the chat logs, I'll join him in one of those, I think. So let me just have a look. Because he did say he wanted to join. Yeah, there we go. I can join him. And there he is. Hello, Oliver.
Hello.
Alright.
Yeah, I mean, it's 3:30 in the morning and I can't sleep. Insomnia for the win, boys.
Fair enough. So Oliver can't sleep, so he's going to watch me drive on the North York Moors.
Yeah, that'll probably knock me off in 5 minutes.
That'll bore you. Yeah, that'll help. Yeah. I'm just explaining though, Oliver, like when Rick goes off to other railways, he's going to be paired with the ROD tender. Like what he runs with it at first until his own tender been built. And then what will happen is that he'll have it left as it'll be left as like a spare, if you like.
Oh, yeah.
So when he goes off to other railways and things. Ah, I did manage to catch animation. He has
when
a teeny tender.
Gallivanting off to poo.
Yeah, when he goes gallivanting off to poo, leaving us to doing poo, and then comes back saying how bad he feels. It's shit. Anyway, this dream's not suitable for children. I don't know why I had to say that already, but yeah. I tell you what, this is the one thing I actually really like about this freeway route, and that is that they have this actual animation here for the crossings, and also the new bridge. They have the animation for the signalman who comes along and gets the single line token and all that.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's really clever, and I think more routes should have that in. And besides, it's nice to have an actually animated human being that, even though it looks really, really rudimentary, it still works quite well.
Hmm.
So, yee.
Just setting up my streaming settings so this can run a bit better on my end.
Oh, someone wants a link to the route. I don't know whether... let me get past this crossing. If you go to Steam Sound Supreme's website, it's in their freeware section. So let me see if I can get a link for you. I need Steam Sound Supreme. I want to watch this, actually, so I'm just going to look at this. Actually, that could be worthy of a screenshot. Ding.
What are the coaches?
They are Gordon Mack / Matrix Trains' LNERT corridors. And they're actually pretty good. I mean, like, I know it's not a prototypical set because I have no idea what carriage numbers and things are for North York, but I'm sure they have a teak set up there.
Mm.
In matter of fact, if the DR wasn't so anal about everything, we'd probably have a teak set. But, you know, no LNER engines mean no LNER teaks. Although, no, saying that, Rick, in his current configuration, with the name boards on the side of his smoke box, you know, I don't know why the camera's so high up, with the, you know, his nameplate on the side of his smoke box there, and then the smaller ROD tender, means, technically speaking, he could be passed off as a what-if LNER engine, especially in the livery as well, because it's basically just LNER green, Doncaster green.
Sort of unstreamlined LNER mountain.
Yeah, I mean, I would say it's more like an...
Because I'm...
You could say it was an evolution of the P2, in a way.
Yeah, because I know the schematic I've seen... Well, it's not really a schematic, but...
The side view.
The one up... Yeah, of Gresley Mountain is basically the A4 with an extra driving wheel, I think.
Pretty much. I mean, that's pretty much all a mountain wants, but... you know, and until.
Oh no, it's a P2 with an extra driving wheel because.
It's no, no, no. It would be a P. It would be a P2 with an extended front end, to have the bogey.
Mm. It's a Cadillac P2.
Yeah, basically. Anyway, while we're sat in the view, let me see if I can go and find the link for that. Oh, hang on, free products, I think it's under. Is it free products and then freeware routes?
Someone said, I think Rick pairs nicely with the LNRT coaches.
I do agree as well. By the way, if anyone wanted a link to the route, I'm going to paste it there. I don't know whether that link will work, but yeah, there you go. There's the link to the route. I will quickly try and edit my description so that it says link for the North York Moors Railway. NYMR4TS. And there we go. It should be the first thing that appears on top of the link. There we go.
Someone's saying LNR P4, LNR P3.
It wouldn't be a P, though. It wouldn't be a P.
It would be an A, wouldn't it?
No. I think the only classification really you could use for something like a mountain would probably be something like Z or X or Y. Because almost everything else was already used up.
Well, yeah, it wouldn't be a V, because that was like the V.
Those were the prairies, yeah. If someone could realistically find a classification slot, I suppose.
Because a P is 282.
Yeah.
I
don't know what. Oh, Q is 080.
What's an A? What's the A's?
A's are Pacifics, Oliver. Come on.
Yeah, 4, 4, 6.
462. No. Okay, Oliver, let me. I'm going to do a brief little bridge with you, okay? Because you clearly don't understand the LNER. So, A were 462 Pacifics, B were 460s, C were Atlantics, so 442s, D, I think, are 440s, E are. I want to say. Hang on, what is that thing that. Oh, E is 240, F was 242. G was 044, I think. I those are the main ones I know, but I know, like, you know, Q is the Q's are 080s, the O is 280 because obviously the LNER 04. So I'm not sure what R is. I think R might have been 084, and then S unless S was 084 and then R was 480. So, I don't know. So, I'd have to have a look at the encyclopedia and see what would make sense.
That would sound cool, though, as an engine name, if they use, like, Zed or something.
Well, you could call...
LNR Z1.
You could call... Yeah, you could call Vic an LNR Z1, or even, like, an X1.
X1? Ooh, that sounds cool.
Right, we're technically at line speed now, so it's... This is the only problem I've got. This is the only issue I'm going to have with the North York Moors stream, is that essentially it's going to be really flat and boring all the way to Gromont. And then, I mean, Goathland, we get to go down the incline. But then when we leave Grosmont, sorry, Gromont, coming back the other way, we get to climb up the one in 49. So.
Someone's just said, I'm more familiar with American steam locos than I am with English locos. Well, you're doing better than me, mate. I'm familiar with none of them. The only one I know is 3801, which is...
That's an Aussie loco. I mean, I'm quite familiar with American locos. Some of them, anyway.
Well, I mean, I'm the main ones, like the big boy and such, but...
Yeah, but there's so many other interesting classes that get overlooked in America, such as... I'm thinking, like, the Pennsylvania Railroad. You've got to think that they built a couple of really big, shiny, you know, engines that people know about. For example... A lot of people talk about the S1 and the T1s, you know, the duplexes, and the, you know, the K4S and the Pacific and all that lot. But not many people talk about the M1, which is the mountain class. And not many people talk about the Pennsylvania Railroad decapods and things like that. Those are interesting. So are camelbacks, actually. Camelbacks are something that we never saw in the UK or Australia. All right, got to put some power on. I'm purposely letting Rick's boiler pressure come down, though, because I get sick to death. I love having the amount of power he's got, but when you're trundling along
the...
How can I put this? He is too efficient. That is the problem. He is so efficient. The only way to get him to not blow off all the time is to literally drive him inefficiently, which is basically me dropping his fire map down. Although I have just noticed that I need to put water in. He's not very efficient on water, He does drink a lot, this boy does, but considering that his main work is going to be over, what, how long did he are? 26 miles, and he's running at those at lower speeds anyway, and his main job is to climb the big hills, he's going to be fine. But again, yeah. I don't know, I'm just thinking of other locos that sort of don't get really recognised very much.
Well, even some British ones that don't get recognised, I'm trying to think.
The Q1, the LNER Q1 I've always liked, which is the Thompson rebuild. In fact, Thompson locos in general don't really get talked about very much. And as we're in LNER territory, might as well talk about LNER stuff. And seeing as Rick is like, you know, especially at this point, if I just quickly do... Oh, hang on. If I move back a little bit.
Was it B12?
Yeah, LNER B12 in Kuala Lumpur.
I watched one of the Steam Locos in Profile videos the other day.
Yeah.
And it was the one... It was one of Thompson's designs that he had to...
B1, do you mean?
It might have been the B1. Where he Thompson... had to throw like, all the niceties out and just full efficiency.
Yeah, you're on about the B1.
Yeah.
Because...
Is that the bongo?
Yeah, the B1s were the bongos, yeah. And that they were named after the sixth member of the class, and a lot of members of... Like, earlier members of the class were named after things to do with South Africa for some reason. I think it was due to some visit from the South African president, I don't know. I'm not going to pretend I'm the biggest knowledge fan of the LNER. I know a little bit, but I'm not like one of these... Like, the only real railway I know a fair bit about is, ironically, the Great Western and the LMS. Which are both railways that, one, I live nowhere near, and two, I shouldn't even really have an interest in, because everybody knows everything about the Great Western anyway. And the LMS, everyone says is quite boring, but... I digress. I think all the railway companies were fine in their own ways.
Yeah, I will admit that some people do get a bit anal in this argument. This railway company was bad. No, they were all fine. They all did it good.
I think I've always argued that like each of these railways had different end goals and different they had different needs and they had different requirements. Like traffic requirement, you look at the LNER's traffic requirements, what they ended up doing most of the time with the LNER, they built horses for courses. LMS, they built mixed traffic designs. The Great Western was similar to the LNER with horses for courses, but they essentially did... I hate using the word copy-paste, but they found the formula that worked and they just adapted it for standardisation. And then the Southern were just fucking... Well, I don't even fucking know. The Southern were bonking towards the end.
In a way... the Great Western was almost the standard bearer for standardisation.
Yeah, basically it was.
They found a formula that worked and they went, right, well, let's adapt that for BR.
Well, they went, right, right, it works, right. Right, he's ready.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that, that's cute. Hang on, Oliver, look. Oh. Don't know if you look on the stream, but look, there's a little doghouse. That's lovely. Just get the dog, sorry.
Woof.
Oh, mate, can you imagine living in that house? Like, right next to the railway? No, the actual house there, like, the houses and all this. I would love to live next to a railway line. I'm not quite sure it would be very good for recording TDRS, though. Can you imagine that? I'm, like, in the middle... Can you imagine, Oliver, though? Like, I'm literally in the middle of recording lines for an episode, and I'm just like, and so, Dave went, and then outside the window you hear, woo! And I'm like, fuck you!
Yeah. What was it? I think it was one of the deleted scenes from the Top Gear tornado race, where they said Clarkson's grandfather, I think, had built his house near the railway line so that he could listen to the trains when he retired. And like the week he finished his house, they closed the line.
Stopped running. Oh, that's ironic. That's awful.
It's ironic, but it's also like sad.
It's sad. I hate to be that guy, Oliver, but as you're sat with me, do you reckon you could do some help with reading in the chat, seeing as I can't at the moment very much?
Yep.
But you say what you were going to say first. Do you say what you were going to say first?
Well, I was just going to say, which would you, because this is something I've seen on the news today, they've opened up a new stretch of highway, so I was like, which would you rather live by, a railway line or a highway?
Railway. Because a highway, you've got cars going along all the time. A railway line, they come every, like, you know... maybe a maximum of every 10 or 15 minutes, at least you get some reprieve. With a car, if you're constantly having to listen to the rumble of cars all the time, you'd get really irritated really quick.
Someone is
getting
a
lag bike.
Must have been talking about the like the different engine classes.
Right.
Someone was talking about the B1s. B1s used a bunch of parts from other engines too. They used the B17 boiler, P2 wheels, and the K2 cylinders. Oh, there you go.
Well, there you go. Okay, yeah, K of 260.
So, in other words, they just went, right, what have we got lying around the workshop? Let's throw all that together and make an engine.
Essentially. I think we're approaching our first stop at Levisham. Is it Levisham?
We actually live near the northeast corridor used by NJT. I'm assuming that's New Jersey Transit or Transport or...
What? Wait, what?
NJT.
M or N? N.
N.
NJT.
For,
oh, right. N for the word I'm not allowed to say.
Nelly.
Yeah, N for the N-word.
I'm assuming... Yeah, New Jersey Transit. There you go. It's just... says, though, I'd rather live in Nebraska next to my favourite big boy, 4023. Q.
Q, doesn't he look Q? I'll tell you what, I'm watching something. I'm assuming some of my viewers will know about this guy called the Unlucky Tug. I'm assuming you've heard of him, Oliver.
I'm thinking he's the one that does the music things, but no, that's the Tugster Intensifiers.
Yeah, I have no idea who that is, though. He is the Unlucky Tug. He does stuff to do with Tugs and Thomas and Friends and all that lot. And I was just watching an editorial he'd done the other day about Thomas and Friends. And what really triggered me was in Big World Big Adventures, right? I already knew it was there, but when I was actually watching footage of... there's a character called Rebecca, and she's supposed to be a bullied Light Pacific.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, and it just as soon as I saw her, I just got triggered, because it's like... Wrong, everything's wrong, kill me now, please, goodbye, death to me. But the worst thing is that he said, in his editorial, he was saying how they could have improved the character by using some of the real life locomotive character flaws. And that is actually something I've done before, isn't it? So that makes me slightly more, like, you know, with 257 Squadron, he's had a chain-driven valve gear break before. Buzz has run out of battery for being a battery electric locomotive. Mr. B's had a gearbox damaged. So, at least, like... But apparently they don't use any of the character flaws of a Blue Pacific, like wheel slip, boiler lagging fire, anything like that, to make her an interesting character. She's just like a blank slate. And they replaced... And they just replaced, you know, two characters with two... Like, you know, one which is supposed to, you know, just a stereotype, typical, you know, token foreign engine character in that near weather, and then they've got Rebecca, which is just like
supposed to be like a romantic interest for Thomas.
I have no idea. I don't even know whether they do romance in Thomas and Friends. I don't really care that much either, to be quite honest, because, you know, Thomas has had many love interests. You've had like what? Well, I say many. I think there's only what Rosie seemed to be that was going to be a thing. Which is kind of ironic, really, because the S-100 tanks were playing the E-2s.
Oops. What was it? See, I haven't watched it in so many years.
I haven't watched it either. The only time I watch it is if I'm watching somebody do an editorial or something. Anyway, here we are at Levisham.
Yeah. Oh, lovely.
Hang on, Oliver.
I have to interrupt you
because you're trying to talk over me again. I just realised we've stopped, there's no boiler pressure, so I get to listen to the sultry sound of the air pump while we're sat waiting, and I love the sound of Rick's air pump. If I just sit here, I can hear it. I don't know what it is, it's literally just the thump, 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 but I like it a lot. Like, I'm going to turn the sounds up on TS a little for a minute while we have a chat, just while we're sat here. Because I love the sounds.
I want to say ASMR, is that what it is?
Are you on about this here? Oh, ASMR, what?
Certain sounds that people find, like, pleasant.
Appealing.
Or something.
I don't know what the word is. Not aesthetic. Ergonomic? No. I don't know what the word is, but... there's certain sounds, like the sound of the air pump, to me, just... I don't know, it soothes me a bit. I could literally just sit and listen to the sound of an air pump all day. It's why I always try and keep Rick at about 25 miles an hour as well, because you'll have noticed if I keep him at 25 miles an hour, he has this really good chuff loop, and I really like it.
Mm.
Don't worry, there's no AI. We can go whenever we like, but...
That's an interesting question. Corey Corbett asks, do you think you would show more episodes showing that while the engines are preserved, freak accidents still happen?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I actually really... I mean, to be fair, we've already had this discussion about an accident that's going to happen, haven't we? About engines and brake blocks and things like that. And we do show minor accidents, but if you're talking about having a major, major accident that lights off a loco, I'm not sure whether I'd want to do that, but...
Well, I mean, we had it with, I want to say Prime Time of Your Life. Is that... Yes?
Was that with Repulse? No. Yeah, no. You're right, we had Colin Cameron Owen, didn't we?
And it has been referenced in, like, the backstory with 257 and...
James, the mogul, yeah.
Yes. That was a freak accident. Although, did you say you were still going to make that as a possible prequel?
I'm not sure. It depends where things go at the moment, because I'm struggling a lot with things, so... Mm. Anyway, we're ready here at Levisham, so let's continue on our journey.
Lovely.
Lovely twins, Mrs. Pottage.
And I don't think it has to be, like, freak accident, I don't think has to be, you know, writes off an engine entirely. Like, I'm trying to think, like, it probably wouldn't be practical in train sim to have an engine have a Blue Peter-esque.
Oh, hang on, I've just got to quieten you up a sec, because we've got the exhaust beat at this low speed as well, with low reg cut off and everything. And you can hear it properly because of, because we haven't got the, safety valve. If I just slow back down again, if we go over these points, I'm pointing the camera up to Rick's smoke box. You can hear it. I love this bit as well. Like the sound, I mean, like, you know, there's just certain sounds that really get me. Just makes them sound really beefy. You know, like really echoey. Can you hear it?
Yeah. No, I've just had to turn the sound up on the stream so I could, and yeah, that's really, really nice, actually. He has clarified his question, saying, no, not like killing an engine, just maybe they are damaged but can still be repaired.
Yeah, there's definitely ideas about that can hang about that happens like that. I mean, I know we've covered it before, but there's still incidents that can happen on the railway.
Is the viaduct, the one that springs to mind?
Well, yeah, Mr. B over the viaduct, you know, both damaging the viaduct and damaging his gearbox.
Mm. And Eustace when he went backwards with the...
Oh, yeah, in Tender Tantrum.
Season 3?
Yeah, season 4, I think it was. Or 5. I can't remember, to be honest. Everything between season, like, 3 and 6 is, like, hazy to me for some reason.
Hmm. Someone's... Oh, here's one you might care to weigh in on. Someone's put, Bullied's Leader was the worst British locomotive ever built. Hmm.
Do I want to weigh in on that? Because I actually kind of agree.
I mean, worse though? I mean...
I don't know. You know what? The big problem with saying worst of something is it's very subjective. Like, I find the leader fascinating. I know it was a buggy piece of rubbish loco because, you know, it didn't work as, you know, the design brief was basically to replace the M7 tank engines. If you take it as... the design brief alone, then it failed miserably in its design brief.
Hmm. See, I don't know. Like, I'm almost wondering whether someone needs to do, like, I don't know if you remember the top reference in Doctor Who.
Nah, not really bothered.
But they did a worst car in the world, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I think the criteria they settled upon was, it ended up being the worst car from a company that should have known better.
Yeah.
So, I'm wondering whether or not someone should whether there should be some sort of similar criteria for engines, like from a local, from an engine company or railway company, sorry, that should have known better. I don't know though if that works, because there's a lot less steam engine designs than there are car designs, so
not really. But I get you. I mean, get where you're coming from.
What was it? There was the Killen Pug, wasn't it? That was built for something, and then it didn't fit that, so it ended up doing
other work.
Something
yeah.
else.
It's where I find an engine fails when it doesn't succeed in the design brief. The Killen Pug was designed to work on the Killen branch as a passenger loco, but it didn't have fuel capacity and it didn't have enough power, so it was both members of the class were dedicated to shunting in the end. So, that says a lot.
Same aspect being E2.
Yeah, the E2 was designed for passenger work and only succeeded
it
could, but you had to write it fictionally into a story.
Yeah. And then it got put on dockyard shunting and couldn't do that either because it was too long.
Yeah, the overhang. It looks so photogenic with the teats, it's unreal.
Sorry, just doing some admin stuff. Tom, would you say that the A4482 would be able to work on any line?
The A4482? Oh, what?
Yes.
Oh, right, yeah, right, I see. Like, if the LNR made a mountain version of the A4, the dad next to driving them.
I think so.
Well, yeah, it would have
been... Well, they're saying one that they sent you. This is King Ori. Saying, would you say the A4482 I sent you, would you be able to work on any line?
No idea, because I don't recall it, to be honest. I don't recall that, but I would suggest that the Great Western Main Line or the East Coast Main Line would be the best ones. Basically, I reckon a 482 could have worked in this country, hence why I designed Rick. I reckon it could have worked with some limitations. You know, all it would have really required was to have, like with Rick, he's got a slightly lower flange on his wheels than normal. Obviously he runs with his smaller tender when he needs to, but... I reckon there could possibly be a case for a mountain class loco in the country. It wouldn't have been very practical, but then again, when Prince of Wales is finished, the P2, you've got to question how practical that's going to be as well. So I think a mountain could have worked.
Prince of Wales is the one that's not going to be streamlined, right?
It's the one that's going to be built to look like the original Cock of the North.
Right, because I know there's meant to be two P2s in production, but...
Yeah, I don't think...
You never hear about the second one.
You've got the P2 Locomotive Trust... P2 Locomotive Company, sorry, I think that's what it is. They're building Prince of Wales number 2007, the new one, which is going to be shaped like the original number 2001. But confusingly, the Doncaster P2 Locomotive Company, they're building a replica of Cock of the North 2001 in its streamlined shape. That is a bit confusing.
Because the first one's done by the ones who did... Tornado, isn't it?
Yeah, so they've got a proven track record, which is why their finances are good.
Yeah. Another question. Do you see the ghosts of Cameron, Colin and Owen either returning or any more of Pogo warning the engines in the future?
Okay, so I don't think Colin, Cameron and Owen are going to appear again as ghosts because, you know, their story arc is done. They're dead now. They're at peace. They've come back to see their friends one last time in Roller Skate Disco, but that's it. As for Pogo giving the engine warnings and things, well, it depends if anything's going to happen, really. I don't know how many times I've got to tell people that I'm still, technically speaking, still in the planning stages. Even though I've written the script for episode one of next season, I need to actually sit down and be in the mood to write the next part of the season. Like, I need to work out where I'm going with it, because I've already decided I might be dropping a character that I was going to introduce. So, it's kind of difficult.
LMS Patriot, the Unknown Warrior replica will be finished. It said it will be completed in 2018, but it's 2020 and the replica has no updates.
Don't ask me, mate.
Yeah. Usually, I would say that if it was set for 20, like, say, a certain date, and it's 2 years past that date, and you haven't heard anything, I would say it's probably a safe bet it's been kicked into the long grass.
No, it wouldn't have been, Oliver. The Patriot is nearly complete.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, have you not seen the pictures of the Patriot, the Unknown Warrior?
No.
Go look it up. It's got a rolling chassis, a cab, and I think the boiler's nearly done.
Google,
oh dear.
Google is my friend.
I've never noticed that before. Vic's pressure gauge is technically speaking not correct. I might see if Squirrel will help me bug fix that at some point. Where are we? Are we somewhere? Ah, we're near, I can't remember what this hole is called, but I'll find out.
So, I'm looking at the LMS Patriot Project website.
Newtondale. Sorry, I'm trying to concentrate on driving, Oliver. Basically, I'm approaching Newtondale Hole. I'm trying to find out what the hole called so I can have a blow up because, yeah, I've neglected Rick's boiler pressure a little bit.
The last update is August 2020, which just says work on the Unknown Warrior has continued at a limited pace since the last report. I love this. This is, you know, hinting at it. Due to the effects of the current worldwide situation.
Well, I mean, they're not wrong, are they?
No, but that could be applied to so many things, like, due to the effects of the current worldwide situation. What, you mean the FIFA? No. The Olympics? No. The other one? Oh. Anyway. So, yeah, there you go. Unknown Warrior is still there. It's been built.
I love whenever I drive Rick, I always seem to drive him from the fireman's side. Don't know how near the top we are, but I need to give Rick a little bit more pressure before we go. I'm not looking after my boy.
Oh no. He sounds all sickly.
Oh, Emilio has asked us, because you're not doing your job properly, Oliver, our favourite American articulated locomotive. Well, you've already said you're the only one you know is the big boy.
Well, yeah, or the, I want to say Challenger, but that's not it, it's not. Is it?
The Challenger is the smaller big boy.
Yeah, the one that's all orange and such.
Orange. Oh, you're all about the are you all about the 611 or the Daylight?
I think it might be the Daylight.
Yeah, that's the...
I don't know. I had a DVD of, like, American Scene that I watched when I was, like, 10. So I'm trying to remember. I just remember one that was orange and red. I think it was the Daylight.
Yeah, but it's not an articulated loco, Oliver. That's the question.
Big Boy, I guess it has to be. Because it's the only one I know.
I think mine would probably be, I don't know what the actual class is. It's, I think it's Norfolk and Western 1218, which is I think it's something like a 2662. Someone in the chat will correct me if I'm wrong. correct me, because it's obviously an American logo, so...
2664, apparently.
Ah, that's right, okay.
I always find that interesting about when you compare, like, American locos to British locos, and it's just like, oh, how can you tell it's American? Because it's got an extra set of wheels.
And much bigger boiler, and much bigger loading gauge, and it's just much bigger in general.
Mm-hmm. I mean, even you look at some of the modern diesels, it's massive.
Y6B, that might be what the class is. Anyway, so Northfield Moors, right?
Yeah. What's it? James Ellison has said in the National Rail, I'm assuming RR is Railroad Museum. National Railroad Museum in Green Bay, you can see the big boy side by side with the A4 Dwight D. Eisenhower, just to show the difference in scale.
So, I would say big.
Big. Actually, that sounds really interesting. What would a streamlined big boy look like?
Oof.
Oof. Biggest oofus. Someone's saying they saw Big Boy 401. How many Big Boys are preserved?
Eight. I think
Ooh,
eight.
Okay.
You got seven static
yeah.
and one operational.
Someone's saying eight as well, yeah. Okay.
Here we go. So, I'm now at the 25 mile an hour mark, so you can hear the shuff loop I like.
Oh yeah, that's the one you use in the intro.
Yeah. I think we've actually nearly climbed over the top of the mall now. What I want to do quick, while we're doing this, is I want to quickly go back to Leversham, and I want to change the points there, and then I want to go up to, oh, we've got age until we get to Goathland, so I haven't got to do anything yet.
Anyway, more questions please, chat, because they're interesting.
Are they?
Well, it gives us something to discuss rather than sitting here in awkward silence.
I like sitting in awkward silence, it's so fun. Get to listen to the sounds of Rick.
biggest Rick. We should get someone. Maybe someone can do a reskin of the big boy into DR Green.
I don't know. I'm not sure that's a good idea.
And you thought Rick was big. Ugh. Someone has said, anyone have a favourite celebrity locomotive?
Kim Kardashian.
What,
next.
Hey, she's going, no. Okay, here we go. Do you have any tips on creating scripts and a series as a whole?
No.
I think the biggest tip would be don't.
Well, no, my biggest tip is that if you haven't got ideas and you have to ask people about how to do it, then you shouldn't be doing it.
Yeah.
Really.
I mean, if you're asking for, like, the technical aspects behind it, but the most important thing is having an idea. This is the reason I haven't made a series, because I have...
I'm Australian.
Yes, that too, but I'm also just empty-headed.
I think it's more to do with the fact that people seem to think you can make a series and make it successful like we do, but at the end of the day, you've got to remember that people like me and Reese were actually not successful in the big scheme of things. It's very rare that anybody, you know, I mean, I look at people like the Lazy Jet himself. I mean, he doesn't write a series, but he's incredibly successful with TS content because he appeals to an audience of Well, as far as I can tell, small children that James Wright would be very proud of.
Plus the other thing, like, there is more to making a series than just here's a railway, here's some trains, here's some voice actors, off we go. Like, I can attest to this as a witness to this. Tom sits here for months banding around story ideas.
And then I probably don't use them.
Yeah, like, so, while, say, Series 9, which came out week by week for the most part, it was basically the whole time since Series 8.
That I'd been planning it.
Was Series 9 in production, up until the time of release.
Yeah.
I think it was only, like, about 2 weeks before those last three episodes came out that you settled on how you wanted to end the season.
Yeah, I think it was, because I was going to do something completely different, I think. But you've got to remember is that I managed to get 4 episodes, like, produced within about, like, you know, filming everything or whatever. I think it took me about, because it was in lockdown, and I challenged myself to finish 4 episodes in 2 days or something like that.
Yeah, like, you got it all filmed on one day.
And then put it all together on the next day.
Yeah.
I'm never doing that again, by the way.
Not unless there's another lockdown. No.
Don't say that.
Don't. You'll jinx it.
Yeah, don't jinx it, because I'm sick of hearing about politics and lockdown and all that. It gets on my nerves.
Will Theo and Otto be making another time machine?
No.
Probably not.
So many questions I've already answered some of these before. I mean, anybody who knows me on the server knows that, like, these sort of questions, they've been answered countless times.
Mm.
And then someone will throw a real curveball and I'll scratch my chin and be like,
not reading that comment, that's fine. Someone is saying that Broadway Limited, I'm assuming that's a modelling company, are releasing HO scale big boys this and next month. Cool.
I mean, cool, I guess. I mean, doesn't interest me at all.
Yeah.
I'm still waiting for someone to build a bully leader for Double O Gauge. I think I put my name down for
Rick.
It. Or Rick, yeah. I'm pretty sure a while ago loads of people said, oh yeah, we're going to try and build a Double O Gauge model with Rick, or, oh yeah, we'd love to build an N-Gauge model or an O-scale model. And yet, you know, as soon as, like, after, like, you know, the Dark Tides and Hitcher came out, everyone just went, meh, and then no one ever made any comments about doing it ever again. Which is a shame, really, because one, I'd love to see more fan work of Rick, like, you know, artwork or, you know, people trying to build models of him or whatever, and all that jazz. It would be nice to see. But, maybe I'm just thinking that he's... I just thought, being my, sort of, my rolling ambassador, if you like, I thought he would be a bit more... Then again, I don't know whether I think I sometimes use him too much, but then other people say I don't use him enough. That's why I'm using him tonight, because I haven't taken him over the Northfield Moors or anything, so I thought I'd give him a bit of love on a stream, but I don't know.
Someone is saying, would Rick ever have a sibling or long-lost classmate? I'm assuming no, because...
Do you know what the problem with this sort of question is, Oliver? This proves to me that people don't watch my content, you know? Because if people had taken the time to watch the 15-minute history lesson on DR-1202, they'd have known that the original one was a one-off prototype, no other members of the class were ever built, because it was just one-off locomotive, and it was scrapped in 46, and Rick is a replica of that locomotive with some slight modification. For example...
See... Yeah, I'm wondering then, not direct siblings, I guess is the word, or classmates, but would there be, like, I don't know.
What other way can you spin it? There wouldn't be any long-lost cousin of a locomotive that has been built, you know, back in the 1930s.
No, I was going to say, like, sort of class adjacent. Like, were there other mountain class engines out there?
As far as my 77C universe goes, Rick is the only standard gauge 482 ever built for use in Britain.
Oh, 2.
Apart from obviously one to the original 1202. But that does make me feel, that actually, like, hearing that now does make me feel a little bit sad that it just gives me that thought that maybe people haven't watched, because I noticed that I thought the Dark Tries on TR1202 would have been a big hit, and it just isn't. I mean, I'm hoping that my project I'm working on with Mr. Eden Green will come to something with Rick, but I've got to wait and find out when, what he wants to do, like, you know, because my idea would be, ideally, would be to, for him to read the wiki article and then ask me if there's anything else that needs to be known. Because, like, for example, the wiki article covered most of it, but I can explain that the, you know, I can explain in a little bit more detail that the prototype history is there, but then the replica history is basically that it was built from, like, 1974 up to 1980, and it was finally finished in 1980, and it ran with an ROD tender, like, you know, little detail tells like that, you know, like it ran with the ROD tender at first because the Southern style tender was still being built, ran in Works Grey livery, then it ran in its unlined DR Green livery, and then it was finally lined out in DR Green, sometimes wears DR Black, and has once or twice been known to be painted into Southern Olive as a what if, but also the fact that it almost works exclusively on the Dark Railway.
Speaking of your videos, I will admit I did like seeing Rick in Works Grey.
Yeah. Well, at the end of the
Whistles video.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was really nice. Also, we've been joined by two other spectators.
Have we?
So, Chris and Andy, introduce yourselves.
Don't do it. It's a trap.
He's Chris and I'm Andy. There you go. That's all you need to fucking know.
Oh, thank God you two are here, actually. That means I might not have to keep listening to,
Oliver. No,
me.
I mean...
Long.
Yeah, I'm boring. Help,
yeah, you're
save
out.
Us.
Oliver, have you got a new microphone?
No.
Maybe you've just got cold.
He got Wingardium Leviosa.
Oh, not again.
Maybe this is what my voice just sounds like at 4:30 in the morning.
What? Hang on, what are you doing at... What?
Insomnia
go to bed.
For the win.
Go back to bed.
Yeah. He can't sleep, I'm bored.
He decided to join me.
So I'm telling him to go back to bed.
Oliver, do what you like, I don't care.
Oh. It's not allowed. You can't do that.
Someone has said you're working with Chris Eden Green, question mark?
Question
so,
mark,
yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Kind of.
But
I think Chris Eden Green
all
is fired.
Will be revealed.
What?
I think he's fired you, Tom.
Oh.
Why have I been fired again?
I don't know.
Out of a cannon.
Because the world's on fire?
Oh, Rick, no. Come on. Don't stop short, you idiot. You fat idiot.
Rick, you idiot,
engine.
You've stopped too soon.
Oh.
Rick, you idiot, reverted to the sports coaches.
So I'll guess by that sound, you're streaming.
No, he's not.
I'm clearly not. Well, no, I'm not, actually. I'm definitely...
Cool. Well, then that means I can say a certain word.
He is, though.
Okay, well, I'm going to say the word anyways.
It's starting to get a little bit mean.
Chocolate ice cream.
It's starting to get a little bit mean in the lounge.
Oh.
Fair.
If anybody gets it, think
yeah,
about it.
Oh.
A bit DJ.
Yeah, it was a bit DJ in there. Oh my God, Andy.
Hello.
It says catch points. Where are they?
It says catch 22.
It doesn't say. It doesn't show many catch points. I'm very.
Well, this is not good enough.
Do you know what this is? This is fraud.
This is false advertising.
This is false ad. False everything. Team.
No, because it wouldn't even be that. It wouldn't even be that thing going forward, is it?
No, that's
no.
A head shunt.
That thing. The thing going forward is.
Tom,
I think
what,
we're
hello.
What? Why is like Rick like pointing downwards, but the rest of his train not?
Because Andy, there's a gradient.
Well, this is not good enough.
It does actually look a little bit like he's really impatient and ready to go, doesn't it? He's just like
a penny.
Yeah, or he's like hunkered down, ready to rock and roll out of this shitty station.
Oh, well,
the station shitty.
Are you still driving on the N Wurmurmur?
Yeah, I'm on the N Wurmurmur.
Wurmurmur.
And we're about to leave. We're going from Grosmont to Goflin to Grosmont. Then we're going to run around I'm going to try and persuade the other half to roll a fag so I can have a little mini break. Yeah. And then, yeah, poof. And then I'll...
No need to advertise.
And then we'll come back up the hill.
More like a pump. What? Oh.
Play petrol pumps.
Anyways, hi, I'm Chris. Now everyone run.
Run.
Not just the women, but the men and the children. Oh my goodness.
What's that sign say? Hang on. S what?
H. It's shunt shunt limit.
Oh.
Get rid of the S and H, right? Put a C and we're in business.
Can't.
Ay.
And you have Tom.
Anyway, time to do the boring bit of the run, which is rolling down the hill to Gromon.
Why is that boring?
Because it's yawn.
Oh, okay.
Why is there an extra bit there? What's the branch line?
That ain't a branch line. That is the main line.
That's not lies.
I mean, this group needs an update to put scenery all the way to Whitby. That'd be nice to do. Because I can't go to Whitby.
Oh.
Yes, Chris. Yes.
You've been banned from Whitby.
I've been banned from Whitby because there's no there's not enough mems.
There's no cheese.
There never was cheese. Right, I need to work out a plan of attack to get into
Fart.
Where the hell is the head shunt? Oh no! Don't tell me I've got a.
Just push the train back up the hill.
No.
Why not?
Because it's silly. I'll work it out when I get down there. Oh my God! What are you doing? Slow down.
Rick will have to go tender first. No.
He already had to go tender first.
Well, we're fucked up.
Yep. Rick gets put on an auto train.
not gonna go full sentimental, but Tom, you feeling better today?
It turned out, I think it might have been the eggs that did it. I'm just really ill.
Yeah. No, I was just like, shit, he's really ill. He needs a rest.
That's fine, and then I've been tumble dry come today, so that's done. It's one of those... I'm really not liking it. I haven't even tried it yet, but I'm reading through the little manual earlier on. And you can use your phone to control it. It's like, it's a freaking tumble dryer. It just dries your clothes. You just switch it on, walk away, and come back like a couple of hours later, and it's done. It doesn't need to be smart.
No, this one also makes your toast, mixes the juice up, and then it also reads Mein Kampf to you.
Well, I said to Trace, right, that it doesn't need, like, it'd be even more amazing if it magically got the clothes out of your washing machine and put them into itself and then did the drying and then took it out and folded it. Now, that would be a smart tumble dryer. But you don't need don't need flipping phone connectivity. Why? You don't need Wi-Fi on a freaking tumble dryer. Why?
This is the thing. Like, I'm thinking, like, the only reason you would use your phone to turn on your tumble dryer is if you were out of the house and needed to dry, like, your pants or something.
Yeah, but then again...
out of the house... You're already wearing pants.
Yeah, but
so
Well, you've missed my fucking point, Oliver. If you're out of the house and you go and switch it on, that means you already had to have put your clothes into the tumble dryer. So why not just switch the fucking tumble dryer right on when you're there? Done!
To quote my favorite Russian YouTuber, Pizdiet, this mother technology.
Huh?
I really downloaded the app.
Boris.
Why? She downloaded the app for the freaking tumble dryer! Why? What?
Not amused.
What is this fottery?
Tumble dries.
She's for real, guys. Like this. Right, Tracy, my other half, right, had downloaded an app to control a tumble dryer.
Yeah.
Why?
In
you don't
case
do anything else around the house anyway.
The tumble dryer on and has gone into another room.
Hang on, Oliver.
Can't be like, oh,
Oliver.
Well.
Oliver, you're talking way too much, shut up, Zach. Tracy, you don't do anything else around the house, so why would you need that? Is it just to add to your laziness factor or something? I'll be like, Trent, can you put the tumble dryer on? Yeah, sure, click, phone.
Yeah, I thought you'd do that.
Eh?
What? Talking to yourself.
Well, she's talking to herself now, see, I'm not even interesting anymore. Well, two can play that game. I'm going to ignore it for a minute.
Okay.
5 seconds later. Food, Tom? Yes, please. No, fag, Tom? Yes, please.
Yeah, basically.
There's nothing good on TV. I know, I'll turn on the tumble dryer with my phone. Oh.
Other than that, I've got to take my car back up to the place I bought from tomorrow or Tuesday and find out if they can find out what this weird rattling noise is or grinding noise. If they'll even look at it, they might just go, oh, wow, you've got the car now. Yeah, but it's under warranty. Is there something not right with it?
It'll give you a chance to see if Tank's still there.
It's not. It's been sold already.
Oh. It's what?
Yep.
But do you happen to know for how much?
£1,295. And they gave us nothing for it. So they made a nice tidy profit out of me.
Lovely. Lovely jubbly.
Oh, this route is laggy. Go away!
Someone has asked if your tumble dryer is a Samsung.
No, it's called Hoover, which is really ironic. The brand is Hoover, but it's not Hoover.
Hmm.
I mean, that is a clap moment right there. Anyway, enough about tumble dryers. I'm sick of tumble dryers now.
Okay.
Let's talk about Andy instead.
Andy is,
a sausage. Loop. How long are we going for?
61 minutes.
Are you joking? It's taking me nearly an hour to do this run, jeez. And I've got to go back the other way yet. Someone
know
said.
You felt that way.
Somebody said Rick with Stevenson Valgear. Hmm, okay.
Mm. He's got, three
separate sets of wall charts, yeah.
Yep, there you go.
I think we still should see Rick with Peniston. I mean, Peniston.
Well, nobody in their right mind are going to try and model that.
Which is a shame.
Chris Wilson, hello there.
No, he won't do that.
I know, he said it.
It can be easy.
Oh, yeah, it's actually easy.
You can't just make up a conversation of Star Wars references. This isn't how human interaction works. No!
Star Wars is banned from my channel, so go away.
You've turned them against me.
Go away.
Goodbye.
Okay. Non-rail related question. What is your favourite underrated ocean line? Yes, it's very underrated, Chris. It's not as if it had a movie made about it.
I actually might have had an interesting answer for this one, but I'm pretty sure that everyone's being really loud as usual, so...
No, go on.
What? No, go ahead.
Aquitania.
Ooh. Ooh. Good job.
So what did the Aquitania do? Because I am not in the know, so fill me in.
No.
Oh. Okay, Google will be my friend again. Anyway. Does anyone know why Wall Sharks Valgear is more popular than Stevenson?
Easier to maintain? Maybe?
Hmm. Yeah, I have nothing to add to that because I don't know anything about Valgear.
I've got a nasty feeling that I'm going to have a problem here again.
Is Rick going to stall?
No.
Oh.
Those crossing gates aren't going to open for some reason. Oh well, we're crashing through the crossing, boys.
Hooray!
It works normally. It doesn't seem to work for Rick, so yeah, whatever. We're crashing through.
Bang! Wallop. Your crossing gates are mine, said Rick as he rolled away.
Man, I keep having to adjust your volume so badly.
Well, am I too quiet or too loud?
Too loud.
Oh.
But that could just be you in general.
It probably is.
No, you can stop. And I'm having the same problem again, where Rick is just at the station, at the end of the line, at the end of a climb, a descent even, and he's just blowing off again, ruining any chance of me doing a voiceover unless I stand about 12 million feet away from him. So that's nice. I think I might also have another problem.
There's nowhere to turn around.
Yeah, I haven't got a, I don't think I'm going to make it on that. I think that's going to be too sharp. So,
yeah.
I think what we're probably going to have to do, I've gone to the wrong platform, so what I'm going to have to do is reverse out and go back in on a different platform.
Yeah, because you could make it if you came in off the middle platform.
Yeah, because I can make it, you can probably make it around that curve there, I reckon.
I mean, can you, do the tracks connect further on ahead or not?
Yeah, they do, yeah.
Well, just take Rick forward then, rather than the whole train.
Oh, no, they don't. They're just platform,
okay.
They're just sidings. So I've got to shunt the whole train back out again.
Back we go, back. Meanwhile, they've just finished replacing the crossing gates.
Trying to blow off some boiler pressure while we're doing this.
I know I did ask for more questions, chat, but some of these questions are really...
This is probably a really stupid question as well, actually, but have you, with the fire mass, have you just let the fire, like, die?
I have tried to let it die, but...
Yeah.
Oh, hang on, guys, got to mute myself a sec.
Yeah.
Do the crossing gates even animate? Yes, they apparently normally do. It's just for Rick they have a problem.
Crossing gates are just crossing gates. That's
the crossing gates were cross. We will not open, they said. Oh, yes, you will, said Rick. Smash.
Are you okay, or are you, like...
No, but... I think that's, you know, standard operating procedure at the moment, so...
I don't even know what a standard operating procedure is. Currently play, like, I'd suggest if you like, you know, gaming and fun times, you should definitely try getting Sea of Thieves, Oliver.
Is that's the
pirate game.
Is it on sale?
I don't know if it's on sale, but it's definitely, like, you know, purchasable, obviously. I usually play with a group of either three or four other people. And we go around and do, like, quests and stuff, which is it's great. And we go after other people and just have some absolute banter.
Now, the reason I'm asking if it was on sale was because I saw something on Steam that was, like, the Steam Pirate sale.
It could have been Sea of Thieves, because so it's really weird. Sea of Thieves is a cross-platform. Like, it's, not cross-platform, but it's, like... So you can play with people that have it on Steam, and because I've got it on the Xbox store, because that was the only place you could buy it for ages. But you can actually, like, and I think you can also play with people who are on console and stuff, which is fun to play. Right. Good.
What's it? $34. I might wait till like, the Christmas sale.
The really cool, like, thing is, like, just going, doing all these quests and, like, taking on other boats and we usually kind of play for, like, I think the last time I played was just before I went back home last week, and we played for, like, 8 hours solid. You get to, like, sort of gain your reputation and stuff. Currently, I've been playing for a little while, but all I'm doing right now is collecting stuff for my voyage. Sort of stocking up the old the barrels on the ship and stuff to make sure I've got enough plies, because you never know if you're going to run into people that want to, because it is literally like, so you get chucked on a server with a load of other people and just left to your own devices. So whilst you're going around doing, like, quests and stuff, they're
guys,
hello.
I'm gonna have a little break, go for a cigarette. So I'm going to leave us looking at Rick for a minute. I'm going to pause it so the boiler pressure doesn't like climb exponentially. And then we'll run around and do the reverse journey. So please try and entertain the audience, and please don't talk about loads of random stuff like Andy's face and Oliver's left nostril.
Talk about Sea of Thieves, if that's okay right now.
Oh, jeez. Okay. All right, I'll be back in a few.
Okay.
I'm going to put a BRB
screen up. I might actually just address something from chat, because there's quite a few questions regarding to like what's going to happen in Season 10.
We have no, like, idea.
Yeah, we have no clue. It's still very much work in progress, so, like...
Tom still has no idea what's going on, so, yeah, like, give us some space, because it's still happening, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Or give Tom some space.
I think, I think Tom was saying he's only written Episode 1. And given
the feed hours usually have
10, there's a lot of... Yeah, so... And there's one question that keeps getting asked over and over and over again. If the viaduct had collapsed and the insurance didn't pay. See, it's a bit hard to answer hypotheticals because
the story was written in...
So if the Soma Viaduct, when it collapsed, if the insurance didn't pay out, how would the engines have coped? Well, I mean, it's a bit hard to answer hypotheticals because the story was written in a way that meant it did. So...
Also, if they'd been left up there, you mean? Is that what they're on about?
Well, I'm assuming that. But then I suppose they would have just had to have gotten a truck or something.
Yeah, probably.
I seem to recall there was something in the episode about they could have a truck, but...
Maybe? Oh,
Brain not working right now. But yes, so Corey, that question was from. I'm just going to say, like, it's very difficult to answer hypotheticals because the story is written in such a way that events did happen. So, oh, he was asking more about how Theo and Otto would cope.
They were just... Weren't they working?
They were in the museum.
They were still in the museum, so, yeah.
Yeah, so, like, I don't think they would care.
Yee.
Because Soma Quarry was already on the way out by that point, as far as I recall.
Yeah.
So... Yeah. I'm not sure how to answer that question, really. Someone's asking favorite Zeppelin. The Goodyear blimp. There you go. Next.
You're a Goodyear blimp.
I am. How did you know?
Because you smell of cheese.
Excellent.
I don't understand this, right? So I'm in a crew of my own right now.
Mm.
Yeah, so I'm just on my own.
Crew of one.
And it's right, so usually when you're in a crew of like many people, you will vote on what you want to do. And yeah, but when you're on your own, surely you shouldn't like have to vote for it. Like I'm on my own. Picked up this quest because I want it.
Okay, but what's the voting thing? Is it like how many people have to vote? I'm assuming it's just one.
What the fuck is this one? So that's something on Kraken's Fallen Scene. It's in a chest and has a sheen. Alright, where the hell's Kraken's for?
Kraken's. Anyway, how was Sink the Bismarck the other night, Andy? Because I know you watched that, and that was... It is a great film.
I enjoyed. Fashion Roaring Sands.
I need more questions so I can interact with chat, but I need questions that I can actually answer, if that makes sense, chat.
No.
No?
No.
Where the hell am I out? It's literally straight north.
Anyway.
Anyway, Who is the only car?
Ah, just got. Horrible.
Oh, mate.
Someone was asking while you were away, Tom, how Theo and Otto would have coped if the Soma Viaduct wasn't rebuilt.
Don't know.
Through drinking.
I was thinking they, well, because they were already in the museum at that point. They were kind of just like, yeah, whatever. Because I think they only really tried to do it with the Tau Cannon to rebuild it because Andy and Abomination were still stuck
up there. Anyway, something interesting of note when you look at Rick from this angle, anyway, with his ROD tender. Check out how wide he is compared to a tender.
Oh no! Don't start the wide again.
No. Copyright music. No.
I've no idea what you're talking about. So.
Wide to Vel. No. Fine. Where's my map? There be my map. Well, I almost fell off my boat then. That would have been stupid, wouldn't it?
Well, you are stupid. What?
That's the spicy meme there, Mr.
Oh, I'm an idiot. I didn't change the points, did I?
Points were badly twisted, Tom. You know what I didn't do? I forgot to check if there were other ships around me, so I might get jumped.
Someone's asked if the ROD tender to Rick is a similar comparison to a Fowler tender to a crab.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, because it's
just
so fat. Or a collet tender to a Dean Goods.
Yeah, they weren't designed to run with the logo, so...
Huh.
Must be a terrifying experience to be slid on the footplate while going round corners like that.
Stand back or you'll fall out, he said. Oh.
Well, I mean, if you're sat on one of these seats, you could easily fall out over the side because there's no handrail on the cab side.
Stop
so.
Crying. I would. I'd just stop crying. I forgot to put my flag up. There will be hello,
Hitler. Okay, here you go. Someone has asked for your thoughts on the Southern S-15s.
Well, it depends on what one you're talking about.
I think he means about the Yuri or the Monsoor.
No, I don't mean that. I mean, he's talking about the one that's in-game, or is he talking about...
Oh, yeah. In-train sim or real life? Please clarify.
Probably in real life. I mean, I did a review of the S-15.
IRL. So.
Oh, in real life? I love S-15s in real life.
Is it was BMG's first foray into like advanced-ish locos, and therefore it's got some of the some infant versions of the stuff that ended up on the Black 5, and at the point that it was made for the S-15, it was just bad. You know what I mean? It was like a test bed.
It's not bad,
but it's holding down R to keep shoveling and stuff like that, which really kind of pisses me off.
Too bad it wouldn't have auto farming on it, so.
Yeah. But I haven't used auto fireman on a steam engine since 2012.
Crashing through the gates in a massive long steam loco.
So yeah, sorry, that person's going in timeout, because no, that question is not at all relevant.
What? No, I want to know what it was now.
I'll
DM
it to you, Andy.
I'll use my phone.
Right, so because Rick won't stop blowing off because he's an arsehole, we're going to get a nice seat. Well, I say seat. We're going to pretend that we're looking out the window of the coach, and we're going to blast our way back up to Goathland. But first, I need to check the points.
Sounds great.
Someone wants to know, do you have ideas for Colossus?
He's a train.
Next.
Thank you. next. Uh-oh, I've screwed up.
Good.
Anchor. Anchor, put the anchor down. Lower anchor.
Right, here we go. Now to try going back up the hill. Hold on, Rick, I wish you'd stop blowing off.
Someone's asked, is it a steamboat? Yes.
Steamboat.
Funnily enough, it is. There's a very loud and massive whistle to suit a very loud and massive loco.
I think a better question for that, Oliver, would be how long will it be a bit until Dexby and the Dark Rail would go to war?
Yeah.
That's a slightly better question.
War of the Railways.
War of the Railways, oh.
Traction Wars.
Damn it. I'm going to be a classic pirate. I've bought myself a Jolly Roger and I'm going to get Jolly Rogered.
From behind.
Not again. Right. Oh, the one thing I didn't do when I was looking at the crow's nest was check for the ship. How clever am I?
How would engines from other railways react when they see it? They would think he'd
probably hit. Cry a bit, to be honest.
Yeah.
I would.
Wait, what was the question? I was in the tunnel.
How would other engines... react to seeing Rick like other engines from other railways? I'm a challenger, actually.
You're a big boy, aren't you? What's a big boy? I don't know, really. Like, I mean, the question is, if you went to a preserved railway and saw this thing there, how would you react?
My sphincter.
you're a big boy, aren't you? No, I'm a big bob. There you go.
Wee. Funny joke.
Yes.
Why have I loaded myself into the cannon?
We're going to go for the classic camera view on the way back on this one.
Oh, hell yeah.
I like the camera view.
It's an interesting railway tidbit.
What?
Someone has put, a town in Mississippi once had a railroad crossing that had neon lights. It spelled out, stop, death, stop. Displayed a skull and crossbones and used a small air siren as opposed to a bell.
Sounds like it sounds like the import scene from the early 2000s, really, doesn't it, Andy?
Yeah, it does, actually. That's not gone very well, Tom.
I know.
Oh no, run.
Does Rick have vacuum brakes or air brakes?
Yes.
Both.
The answer to that question, Tom, is yes.
He has all of them. He's like Abomination. He's literally like a scaled up version of Abomination because he's even got an auto-jector in canon.
Huh. Does he have?
Because when was the original 1202?
1968.
I know it was before World War II.
1933 was when the original was built, and it was rebuilt in 1934.
So yeah, effectively, imagine Rick is a 1930s design with 1980s, or 1970s, sorry.
Technology.
We have the technology.
Well, I mean, what is it? The extra things he's got is that he has roller bearings, he has an auto-jector, he has slightly higher boiler pressure, I think. He's also got the side window cabs. He's also got a better blast pipe arrangement.
Fuck you, Snake.
I'm trying to think. Wasn't that similar to Abomination?
I love how I literally just said that, Andy, didn't I? I literally just said he's like a bigger version of Abomination.
Oops.
In his own words, that was. Oh,
see, this is where people don't listen to me.
Bottom.
Fuck off, Andy.
The banter is just coming all over the place.
I mean, the only difference really is that Rick doesn't have a diesel ejector. He's got a he's got a diesel ejector, Andy. No, he's got a Lemaitre exhaust.
Ooh.
Bit like a Bully Pacific.
Pacific. So he sounds like he's doing a lot, but actually he's not.
He's got a very soft... He's meant to have a very soft exhaust beat.
Yeah.
And yet everyone was like, oh yeah, you need to put boat deflectors on him. It's like, no.
New.
It ruins the aesthetic. And then people are like, yeah, but what about all that stuff on this side? Doesn't ruin the aesthetic.
Well, that's supposed to be there.
It's meant to be there, part of the design.
Because he's an industrial loco.
What?
You're
an industrial
loco. Oh my god, can you imagine that? Like, just putting Rick into National Coal Board livery.
Do it. Right now. How's this stupid rock boat?
And now Tom shall live stream a reef skin.
No.
No, I shall not.
Now Tom won't. Oh, hello. Look at you. I want to talk to you. You sound.
Because I'm trying to think with the smoke. See, I want to say smoke deflectors, but that would just make him look like a big.
It'd make him look like a BR standard.
Yeah, it would make him look like a big Britannia or something.
I mean, basically, he already is because of the shape of his front end here.
Mm. He is a bit shapely.
Said Rick and NCB running on the
All I heard there was running on the
bitch.
I heard run on the fish.
Oh, fair. Well, bitch fish.
Rick in National Coal Board livery, running on the Mardi bridge.
Mate,
there'd be literally no point in having any other loco.
It wouldn't fit on the Mardi branch's curves.
I shall pull all the trucks.
I just love the idea of, technically speaking, Rick is an industrial.
Yeah, pretty much.
Rick with a tornado siren.
What?
Probably not.
Why though?
Rick with a Stuka siren.
I was trying to work out whether he'd actually have a Lemaitre exhaust or whether he'd have a Lempor injector. Ejector even.
Laminator.
You reckon you should stick with a Lemaitre one rather than a Lempor?
Yeah. No, I think it fits the region better.
Yeah. Well, being three cylinder doesn't really fit. Well, actually, no. Technically speaking, three cylinder does work because he had the N1 and the S and the U1 even, and then later the Bully Pacifics.
It's bullies.
Because I think Rick actually, like, the reason that the later the design had a Lemaitre exhaust is because of Bully in the late 30s.
Yeah.
Like, he would have originally had just a bog standard chimney exhaust, but then I think when Bully came along and put him on his the schools and the Bully Pacifics and all that, Lord Dark most likely spoke to Bully about it, or Mr. Dark even, and they probably fitted the Lemaitre exhaust. So when the replica was built, it just had a Lemaitre exhaust as well, just for continuity's sake.
Yeah, that makes sense. Oh.
Gotta love watching this Valkyrie go round and round.
Yeah.
I do love how someone said to me, like, a load of people said, oh, why does it connect on the third axle? Like, it's really unusual. It's like, no, it isn't. Look at Somerset and Dorset 7F.
7F, yeah. Be like 7Fs here.
I mean, that's where Rick gets, like, he's inspired by a lot of things. Like, you know, that you could inspire Valkyr by the 7F, front end by a BR standard, overall design from the LNER, tender from the Southern,
yep,
chimney from the Southern. I suppose LNER as well for the cab.
Mm.
Bear in mind, it was built at Bear Peacock originally.
Yep.
Someone has asked, how much tractive effort would you say Rick has? And I think
we worked it out. Yes. We worked out about £55,000 of tractive force. So he's above a 9F, but below the U1 Garrett. So he would have been probably one of the most powerful steam engines in the country, based on tractive effort alone.
Didn't we work it out to be something like it would be the equivalent to a 10?
10 or 11.
A 10 or 11F.
Well, yeah.
Are you going with F, or are we going with, like...
Well, I go for M. Yeah, I'd say... I jokingly put 10MT...
Yeah.
But it'd probably be something like 10P11F.
Yeah, that makes more sense.
Yeah.
Mm. Kind of fun, though. Whatever you're looking at, it's quite fun.
He's a fun loco.
I just like the fact that we've managed to get something like that. Like, you know, thanks to you and Anthony and all, and obviously Chris eventually, like, something like that has ended up in-game. It's nice to see what...
It's nice to see more big fictional locos. I mean, like, we're looking at... lots of things at the moment, and it would be really nice to have more fictional locos like Rick in game. And then the good thing is, like, even though you know, he'll probably be surpassed in the future by other developers or whatever, or I don't know, it depends what other people are doing. At least I can turn around and I can be like, well, Rick was the first big fictional locomotive put into TS.
Yeah.
Well, we all know what I'd like to see, but we'll hold judgment on that until it, you know, eventually happens. But I'd like to see people design a loco, but like, because you know, like it's all well and good seeing like fictional stuff that could have happened beforehand, but like
you don't really see many proper fictional designs like this, do you?
Yeah, no, exactly.
So bear in mind that like I drew a picture based on like my imagination. Anthony then reimagined it as how it would have looked as a real engine, and then Mr. Wilson has built it as, you know, as close to a real locomotive as he could get. Like there's differences, but you know, between Rick and say like, you know, the drawing I did and the drawing Anthony did. But you know, to actually see a full scale locomotive that is completely fictional put into a game such as TS. I mean, like, I know people have done it in like Train Zed and stuff, but
yeah,
this is like completely like nothing like him has ever been designed before, if that makes sense. He's so unique. That's why I love him so much, because he is so unique.
We need more of that.
We need more engines. Yeah, I'd love to see things like, you know, like a 464, maybe. A British, like, British outline, like a 464, or say, you know, like I'm thinking even something like the BR Standard 282, but, you know, like, Rick is basically not based on any particular prototype at all. He's completely fictional, like, you know. I mean, who would design an engine with, you know, a boiler the size of the space shuttle, completely parallel, a firebox that could probably literally burn your roast dinner to death by putting it on the shovel, you know? No other real designs like Rick are out there, and that's what makes him a bit unique. I mean, like, you know, he built, essentially, you could call him, and I don't really like the term, because he technically was built as a mainline machine, and you know, to mainline standards, because he was working on the line that required it. But technically speaking, he is an industrial.
Yeah.
And that's kind of sad to think about, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, now that you mention it, because you said 1933 is when Rick was put, like, out of shop.
DR-1202,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah, sorry, the original. When would, like, the designs have been laid down? Schematic and such.
Well, it's probably the same year.
1932 like, or the beginning of 1933.
Like,
it would have been a bit of a rush job, because
be
Lord.
Like,
thanks, Oliver, for letting me explain. By the way, you're doing a really good job, pal. Well, you asked me for an answer, and I'm trying to give you an answer, and you're talking over me, man.
Sorry.
It would have been probably done end of 1932, beginning of 1933. It would have probably been slightly rushed, because you can tell it was rushed because he was outshopped with this tender. Like, he didn't even have his actual tender designed. He didn't have a tender designed. It was just, oh, we'll take an old tender from whatever. So they just took an ROD tender. So.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Anyway, carry on now. I'm sorry. You wanted me to answer your question, so.
Yeah, no, I was just going to say, because Rick almost, like, because you're saying who would build this, but it almost reflects almost the mindset of, say, the Roaring Twenties. You know, everything's big and you know, better and such. And,
well, I suppose, look at the Royal Scots, as they were built, with the big parallel boiler. Both have where, I mean, Rick's boiler is absolutely fucking gigantic compared to those, but you can see where the influence comes from for big boiler, high boiler pressure, for the time, because eventually we had like the Blue Pacifics and the Counties ended up with 280 PSI boilers. Rick's is pressed to 275, so it's not that bad. I think the original was probably I think the original locomotive might have even been pressed to 255 or 265,
which is still quite high, especially for like
for the time that period. Yeah,
exactly. Yeah.
I think the word we use for Rick is chonk. He's just chonky boy.
Chonky.
Someone's wondered what a British duplex drive loco would look like. Because that would be a...
Well, we've already seen one.
64.
technically speaking, the Greater Britain and most of the LNWR web compounds were duplexes. Because they were separate drive, but they were on the same rigid frame rate, but they were more commonly known as double singles.
Double.
But the same contact is there, it's still a duplex.
Got duped, mate.
I still find it difficult to believe that Rick is actually a three-cylinder machine, you know?
Hmm.
Like, it's... as if he wasn't already overpowered.
You just give him two massive... Yeah,
but that's the reason he's got. I'm going to say the reason he's got three cylinders because his actual outside cylinders are quite small for loading gauge issues.
Yeah.
That's why he's got the third cylinder for the power.
The original one had four, wasn't it? Because I seem to remember it was.
The original design with the Pennington valve gear had four cylinders.
Hmm.
When it was rebuilt, the middle cylinders were taken out and converted into just one cylinder, which was a weakness on the original. Locomotive throughout its whole life, which was because it had never been intended to be a three-cylinder. All of the interiors of the locomotive, like the inside valve gear and the inside cylinder, because they were using the frames that had originally been built, it had to be moulded in, if you like. Whereas Rick, because he's built from the ground up, because that's where most of the design change has gone into, which is the inside valve gear and cylinders, because he's still got a separate set of wall charts in there, but... there's better lubrication points for it. Like, the lubrication points you'd have to get right in underneath the loco. That's why he's so wide as well. That's why he got all the rigging on the outside of him. For ease of maintenance.
It's like if you took some of the, cylinder pistons out of a V8 and then tried to run your car. For
example. Not really.
Oh, okay. Has been another interesting session of Oliver talks out his ass. Excellent.
I mean, yeah.
You're not right. I mean, yeah. Sorry. Oh, but hi, Oliver.
Hello.
All is good. The Roaring Twenties.
I had a fleet of steam shunters.
I had a fleet of industrial fucking.
I had Rick my mainline going engine.
My ocean going
steam engine. Yeah, what you do, right, Andy, is you just, you know, like rolling roads.
Yeah.
You just stick Rick inside the bowels of like a massive steamship, and put him on a rolling road, and that's what powers the engines. Can you imagine that? Just how complex would that need to be?
The original marine engine.
Yeah, it's a marine. Oh, mate, can you imagine Rick with a Yarrow Marine type boiler like the Hush Hush?
Yeah,
properly be a galloping sausage then, wouldn't they?
Slalloping.
Can you just imagine the confusion on the face of an engine? Looking and all right, let's have a look at it. What? It's just a steam engine hooked up.
What the?
On a rolling road.
What the fuck? Andy, why is that? Oh, Andy, is that from the Critical Drinker, by the way?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Go away now.
Anyway, that's all I've got for today. Go away now.
Go away now. Mate, that's great. We like him. He's good.
There was Rick, my ocean going tuck.
The Roaring Twenties, a fleet of industrial combine artists.
And a switcher, Abomination. And then we had Warrior, after the Warrior of the Class 52.
Garbage.
Garbage.
There ain't no garbage.
So Eustace would be Top Hat.
I say hello there.
Jesus Christ.
So does that, wait.
Oh, I'm too late to save the day.
Oh God, are we playing this now? We're going to play Tug characters and TDRS characters. Let's go.
Yes.
Sunshine. Four eight. What's the number of the AF that's up at the Keeflingworth Valley that I used? 48 7 7 3 48 1.
Oh yeah, but is that the one that's voiced?
That's
by?
The one that Jordan voiced. So Jordan would clearly have to voice it.
we need a little tank engine to be
Sunshine, Manning Ward. Steamy John.
Steamy
Just use Steamy John as a stand-in for Sunshine. And then you've got 10 cents would be what? 10p? 10p, and that would be what? That would be, yeah, Smokey Joe.
Smokey Joe and Steamy
John. I'm going to make a special on that, Smokey Joe versus Steamy John. I might do that on Tuesday or Wednesday.
Instead of tugs, would it be tanks? Because they're tanking.
This is tanks.
Bang, bang, bang.
No, but then you'd have to do it as like, you know, I had a Panther tank. My war going tank. Tog 2.
Oh, yes, Tog 2.
This was something we bandied around for Tales of New Wessex, but I always was suggesting to Andy he should just make Lord Stavell just a funnel in a wall.
I mean, okay. An Loud Hailer, you mean?
Yes.
A funnel in a wall? I ask you, Oliver, seriously. Terminology, man. Come on.
So are
you.
Well, technically, it was a funnel in a window.
A funnel window.
So which character would be Big Mac? It'd be Clyde, wouldn't it?
Clyde, yeah. He could change himself into one.
He could change himself into an ocean-going tug.
Oh, my God.
Ah, but...
Yeah, clearly you this in top hat.
Yeah.
Which one would be Blue Nose?
None of them.
None of them.
I have spoken.
Fuck it. Who's the Hitler of the TDRS series? It's Leander.
Yeah.
So that'd be Blue Nose.
Leanne Hit.
No, why not Liz?
Oh.
I know we've never actually seen Liz because she's an old friend of Ed and Sid's, but she was fucking nuts.
One off on one.
She would go off on one on anything.
Someone has suggested Howard as Blue Nose.
No, I can't see it. I can see him more of as... Yeah, he's more like Johnny Cuba. Who would be Zorin? We ain't laughing, Dr. Beeching.
God damn.
Oh, mate, yeah, no, Howard then is Zorin.
We ain't laughing, yeah, actually. Oh, that's.
I like the bit about being better looking. That'd be Alan.
That would be.
Alan is Zach. Zip and Zug would be Theo and Otto.
Jesus.
Mr. B would be one of the Zeed tugs, probably.
Nah, he'd be,
No, I'm trying to think who's got... Oh, Goose would be Zebedee. Because he's got, like, varying loyalty, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Captain Joker... We're laughing, Mr. Dark! No! I just thought I want the best thing! We need to do a tugs thing, but I need Ben Dexby's help. Because it'd be Dexby Railway... It'd be the Dexby Railway Fleet and the Dark Railway Fleet.
Oh my god.
So, Captain, like, Admiral Chonker would be, like, Zorin.
We ain't laughing, Mr. Dexby.
We ain't laughing, Lord Dexby.
Dexby wow. Engines all pulling gunpowder vans. And if those dark railway engines try to get in your... Oh, we blow them up. Yes, but with your horn, with your whistle, horn. You idiot. Horn? Horn. Yes, horn. Dexby engines have horns. This is canon now.
Honk.
Honk.
Ooh. The sail's gone a bit. Ooh. Doesn't he look
cool? Doesn't he look cool? They began to sing, bitch.
Oh, holy shit. Oh, God, no.
So so now we've come to the massive conclusion that Rick is indeed a big industrial loco.
Big fish. Oh, wait.
Excellent.
Oh.
Yeah, he is. He is massive.
Basically, we're selling into the National Coal Board.
Pretty much, yeah. Only on
My God, look how... It's so weird being on this side of Rick looking back, because he's so freaking... Boiler's so fat. Are you calling me fat? Oh, mate, fat-shaming Rick when he comes in. It's just like, oh, he's so fat. Did you just call me fat? And then he just goes off and, like, you know, he's begging, like, you know, begging for a smaller boiler.
How much water?
I've just thought of another Tugs TDRS comparison.
Mm-hmm.
Lino would be OJ.
Oh, yeah.
Never fought when I was a young engine.
I've told Mr. Dark to get my cylinders looked at!
I think everyone's waiting.
What about, Hercules? That would probably be Colossus.
Would it?
Would it?
Maybe.
I thought Rick was our ocean going engine.
Yeah, Rick is the ocean going engine.
Oh.
I'm gonna, you know what, after the stream I'm gonna try and get that Captain Bazza paddle steam and see if Rick fits on it so it could be an ocean going steam engine.
Bonk.
God's sake.
Who would Hannah be?
Sally Seaplane.
Or Lily Lightship.
Lily Lightship, yeah. Our mate gets touched up by did that mean Dave and Grampus?
Oh. Oh, what the flying bananas is just that? I'm going the wrong way.
They're going to blow me up today.
She's going to give me a blowjob today.
Honk.
Honk.
That's honky.
You're honky.
I know. What are you going to do about it, huh?
I'm going to honk all over your honk.
Oh, not again.
And I think collectively, Colin, Cameron, Owen would be
the Ghost Fleet.
Krakatoa.
No, they're the Ghost Fleet. Look at that shed go!
You big Mickey.
I might have to edit that together.
Oh no.
Oh hi.
Oh hey Hannah, what brings you?
Oh hi Hannah.
Look at that tramper.
Jesus. Get back, Hannah, it's not worth it!
Oh dear.
Alright, harder starboard.
Stop
what
it.
What about Big Mickey? Yeah, Big Mickey's frame.
Oh no, but Big Mickey should be Big Bob!
Big Boob.
Big
Bob.
Boob.
Yeah.
We're not stopping at Newtondale, fuck them. If anyone's at Newtondale wanting to get on the train, they're stuffed.
Jump out the window.
Yeah, basically. It's just like, hey, look, there's a train! Finally, I can get out of Newtondale Hall! Why is it not stopping, Daddy?
Yeah,
you just whistle that, you know, just like...
84 years since the last train. Oh.
Meow.
Fucking meow. Why is my... Where's the wing? Oh.
Because you're a fathead.
Puffer. Who would be Puffer?
Fucking all of them.
It'd be the bus.
Yeah, Rupert.
Yeah. Someone said Grampus is Rick. No, No.
Look, everyone can't be Rick, okay?
Yeah.
Rick is Hercules, end of.
Here is Tugs. Every character is played by Rick.
What do you think about that, Rick? Well, Rick, that's a very interesting idea.
Interesting question, Rick. Well, I think, Rick, that I, Rick, I'm going to tell you, Rick, that every other Rick in the world is fake. Oh, we still need to give Rick a break van called Morty.
Yes. And it's painted yellow.
We're going to go on an adventure, Morty.
No. I just want to go to school.
No, you don't. Oh, I've screwed up slightly. Right, anchor. Lower the anchor. Set the sail length up. Oh, God, that's not gone well.
I'm going to set your sail length up in a minute.
Oh, mate.
Mm.
I actually did it.
Who would Barry be?
He would be Barry.
Yeah, you can't change him. He's just Barry.
Barry
could just be Puffer then, and it's just like, Puffer, you need to help us. Go to Uptown?
Uptown, yeah.
Yeah, go to Uptown. He's just like, no, I'm on my break. Go away.
I'm going against time to have my chicken. Pie.
Actually, I wanna edit that. You know. Exploding and everyone's saying shout for Puffer, and he's just like, no.
I'm on my break. Go away.
What?
Me sideways. Simple.
Come on, Barry! No.
Who would be Burke and Blair then? The BR men.
Inspectors, yeah, those BR inspector dudes.
Yeah.
The Dexpectors! Yeah, there you go, the Dexpectors!
The Dexpectors.
The Dexpectors from Dexby. Oh, we'll give you a very fine price for Fear and Otto. We'll give you a fair price for Lino, cut him up immediately.
Who was the one?
Frank,
and there was another one.
Frank and Eddie.
Yeah, the two.
Well,
yeah.
Well, clearly Eddie's got to be Eddie.
Ellie
and Eddie. Yeah, Ellie and Eddie. Yeah, that'll do.
Now it's always our fault, isn't it?
Never his Eddie.
Sea Rogue would be God. Who would Sea Rogue and his uncle be?
Ed
Sid!
Sed and Pid.
And just sitting just going out there being a pirate and just like, I don't want to steal any more stuff! I've been rambled! Why are we doing this again?
Why not?
I don't know. It's fun. It's the most fun we've had so far, so...
That's not very nice.
I know, right? Rick is well upset.
Yeah.
Oh.
Look, oh. You not see him. Can you not see him crying? Hang on, I can make him cry. I can make Rick cry. Are you ready? Like, watch this.
He's just gonna overfill his boiler.
No, look. Look, he's crying out of the back of Nintendo, look.
Oh. Or he sprung a leak.
Browse the gold hoarders off it.
Yeah, the captains would be...
Mr. Dark and Mr. Deckby.
Would it be Mr. Dark or Zeke Dark?
Mr. Dark.
Mr. Dexby. Mm.
Zeke would just be like, you know, some random pleb.
Some random pleb.
And Mr. Smash would be like, No, actually, Mr. Smash would be Big Mickey, because he's never working at 4 o'clock.
What was the one that was jinxed?
Boomer.
Who would Boomer be?
Well, which engine has the most bad luck? Dave. He's constantly being killed by ex-girlfriends, you know?
Okay, Dave.
Page. Where the fuck is this?
North York Moors Railway.
Oh. Look for somewhere.
I said Repulse could be Boomer.
I received a quest.
Maybe.
I'll do you a quest.
Oh, thanks.
It's too bad Chris has dropped out. Someone's just put Blueberry for Boomer.
Hey, Boom Boomer?
Buckleberry.
Buckleberry more like, am I right? Oh.
Topus Kekus. I don't know why, I just imagine riding on Rick's cab, right? But then, like, seeing this little teeny weeny tender after you, like, would you not be shitting bricks all the time that's going to derail because it's so small compared to how big and how massive Rick is, as in, like, his actual mass?
He is yeah. Fat, mate.
He's the pH fat controller.
He is the pH double D.
Just had to put someone in timeout because they keep repeating the same comment, and that is silly.
Is it the one about USA and China going to war?
No, it's another one.
Oh. Is it Daft Bunkin' playing at my house?
Oh, not again.
No, they were basically saying that an engine changing livery and paint colour would be like changing skin colour. Like, no, that's...
What?
No.
Not really.
No. Back in your box.
I just want to point out, these are inanimate objects. Like,
yes.
Watch it, you! Don't call me. You might think your engines are all fucking inanimate objects, but mine ain't. Mine are alive.
They're very animated.
In my heart, they're alive.
I don't have a heart, so.
Oh, well, that makes sense.
Well, yeah. The thing to remember is while they may be imbued with human characteristics, they are not, in fact, human.
Yeah, but neither is your dad.
I mean, clearly he was a tortoise.
Test tube.
I thought he was.
He was a tortoise. Funny joke.
Yeah, so someone's just put, I figured paint would be similar to clothing. I think that's...
Accurate.
When they're in primer, they're naked.
So when Rick comes out in work grey, does that mean he's actually like a toddler that's just been born with no clothes on or anything?
He's in a diaper.
Yeah, he's in a diaper.
Diapers.
You're a diaper.
You're a diaper.
Your uncle's a diaper.
No.
Or like the what's it? The blanket they put babies in just after they're born. There you go. He's in a blanket.
Is his name Blanket?
Yeah. Big blanket. That's what it's called.
Big fuck it.
Big old
So has anybody got any actual questions about Rick that we haven't answered yet? I'm going to throw that out to the audience, seeing as we're nearly at the end of this, and I'd like to see if there's any interesting questions about Rick.
Yeah,
and please don't be, when is he going to be introduced into the series? Because that'll be when 1980 comes. He was built in 1980.
There is one.
Oh.
Will new build Rick have the four mortal tender?
Will Rick have what?
a four-axle Mansell tender.
Well, that's what he was built with, so yeah.
Nigel Mansell.
As in, that's the tender that was designed to go with Rick.
Yes.
Because he's running with the... when he's first out-shopped from Carcass Smash Limited, a spare ROD tender has already been sourced for him to run with while they're finishing up his proper Mansell tender. And he's going to run like that to represent DR-1202 as it would have come out of Bear Peacock in 1934. Because when it came out in 1934, it still had the ROD tender, but it had to rebuild with the Wolf Sharks gear and everything. Then, once he's been on display and done some test runs everywhere around the railway and whatnot, once that other Southern tender is built, he will be given the Southern tender. So, yes, he does have a Southern tender. He also has a very fat nose.
Someone's asked, what would be under the cover between the smoke box and boiler casing?
Oh, is he on about... oh, I know what he's on about. I'm going to go to it and I'm going to tell you exactly what it is. Are you on about this up here that is near the camera? These giant things on the top of his boiler? Is that what they're on about? Because if so...
Yes.
Right, those are the superheater headers. The superheaters come into those bits. They're the superheater header covers.
There you go.
So, there again, Rick, for being an engine built in 1933, he already had quite highly superior superheating because he had LNER-style superheating installed.
Which would also ask the question, why does Rick have LNER? Because...
why does he have what?
LNER nameplate.
Because the idea is that when he goes off to preserved railways like this, his... DR nameplates that usually sit on his sides are taken off, and these ones that are put on his smoke box sides are put on instead. Very similar to what they do with Clanline, which is they won't put her... is it the red nameplates they won't put on her at preserved railways, or the black ones, Andy?
Which one's she usually... isn't it
the... I'm sure she usually wears the red ones, doesn't she?
From what I remember, yeah, I was trying to...
and she wears the black ones when she goes to preserved railways. It's a similar concept to that. When Rick is at home, he has his normal nameplate. But when he goes off to other preserved railways or runs on the main line, if they want to get... like, sometimes they won't bother sending with a nameplate. Other times, they'll give him the smaller nameplates. And the only reason I asked Chris for them was because of how LNER-ish he looks. So I thought it would be a nice little nod to the LNER, seeing as we don't have an LNER logo currently on the DR. So Rick basically fills in that gap of being pretty much every region. He got elements from everywhere. I think the only region really he hasn't got really much influence from is the NMS. Mm. Any more questions?
Let me have a question.
Go on then, Andy.
Can Rick do something crazy?
No, taking the piss. You know, that guy.
Right. Don't be a cunt. We'll kill you.
It's not very nice.
How often do you think Rick would be... pulling rail tours and away from the railway?
Well, for one thing, he probably won't be doing any of that until about 1984 or 5. But I imagine that he'll have to do it. He'll run a couple of rail tours, but he's not going to run many. He's probably going to be one of those engines that only runs one. I think maybe in his second boiler ticket, because I think by the 90s, we're getting towards approaching the mainline connection at Barbourne. Late 90s, early 2000s, I think. But I think Rick will visit other preserved railways. I think, to be honest, he's not really that suitable for the main line, to be quite honest.
Plus, it would be...
loading gauge restrictions would be an issue.
Yeah.
I think he'd probably find it. He'd be one of these engines that would probably... I don't know, I might even make it so he does run a rail tour or two in the south of England by being taken off by lorry to somewhere. So he goes off and has an adventure off the railway, and he sees what the big railway is all about and how much prejudice there is towards an engine like him, because there's never been anything like him on the railways of those that time.
Ooh. Rick versus the armchairs.
I can imagine that. It would just be like, you're not a real locomotive. I am.
Yes, I am. I'm here. Look, I'm real.
I am. I exist. I have steam in my boiler. My steam runs my cylinders. I can pull trains. And they're like, yeah, but you're not a real engine, are you? It's like...
You're not like a flying scootsman.
You're not like flying scooter. I don't know, I'd have to work that out. It really depends, because like it depends just where I take him, really. Because at the end of the day, he's going to basically... as soon as he's built, he's going to become the flagship of the Dark Railway, and everybody's going to be flocking to see him. and the railway's going to be incredibly busy. And I love the idea of a story where people are so disappointed one day when they come to the railway to get behind Rick and only to be confronted with Dave instead. And then they're like, oh, we don't want to travel behind this engine. He might be painted the same colour as DR1202, but it's not him. And Dave's just like, oh, you lot are fucking charming, aren't you?
It's not very nice.
It's not very nice. It's not very cash money of you, is it?
Koosh.
Still very cash banuka.
Any more questions? Because I got a question.
What's your question, Tom?
Well, actually, my question's kind of an interesting one to myself. Why is his number 1202?
It'll be...
Because technically speaking, think about it, Theo and Otto are number 1 and 2, and they were built specifically for the railway, so technically speaking, Rick would have been 3. DR1202, anyway, would have been number 3. But then the problem with that is that the amount of Henry references I'd get would be unreal.
He is a bit green.
He is a bit green, and he is a bit Henry-ish.
It would be Unreal Engine.
Unreal Engine 4. I don't know why his number is 1202. It's really weird. It's just a random number. I suppose it's just because it was in build number at Bear Peacock. You know, lot number 1202, so they just gave him the number 1202. So it just stuck. And the other question before someone asks it is why isn't Rick numbered 1203? It's because he's a replica of the original locomotive. Although yeah, technically speaking, he should have been 1203, but because he's had so many mods. But fuck it, who cares?
But given he's a replica and not the next one in the class,
yeah,
that makes sense.
He's meant to represent the locomotive as we built, but with the extra modification to the cab, really. And a lot of the other stuff on him is superficial, I suppose.
I'm trying to think. What's the GWR engine they're building? Like the new one?
Is it the County?
The County, which is being County of Glamorgan, which obviously already existed, but
No, Andy, sorry, can I correct you? It's not a County class, is it?
Oh, it's a modified hall.
No, it's a County class. Remember?
Oh, sorry. Yeah. I apologize.
County class number 1014, everyone. The other new build, Oliver. The other new build, Oliver, yeah. Is there's another county class, County of Montgomery.
Which is the Churchwood County.
And there's also the Newt.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Which we're all waiting, me and Andy are waiting for both in real life and in train sim. So if the Forge is watching, can we please have an update on it, please?
Isn't the Nigel in real life going to be the next one?
It's really odd how it's really weird how that happened, because some engines are replicas of like, you know, quote unquote replicas, but others are numbered next in line. I suppose it really just depends on the project mood, doesn't it, really, when you think about it.
I remember also hello.
God, hello Anthony, fucking hell, hello.
Spying on you for that fight.
We were saying nice things about you earlier on, didn't you hear them? We were saying about how you helped bring Rick into life anyway.
Rick.
Anyway, Karen Anthony, sorry.
With things like the County, for example, I think the main reason they went for County Glamorgan was because of the project's origins in the Barry 10.
Yeah,
and because it's named because Glamorganshire is where Barry's scrapyard was.
Engines like the Patriot are because you can't go next in line with the Patriot, because the next number after 5551 is 5552, which was Silver Jubilee. And then, obviously, Beachy Head is Beachy Head.
Two people have asked this question. Would Dave be jealous of Rick?
At first. I think he would be at first, but I've always said to you guys, one of the main things I want to happen is that Dave takes Rick under his wing and actually looks after him because everyone else starts picking on him. Because bear in mind that he might be absolutely fucking gigantic and bigger than every other engine, but he's still young. He's still a young engine. He's not exactly, you know, he's not got the years of experience to be able to deal with that sort of situation. So I think Dave would feel sorry for him and look after him. Because he didn't ask for it, did he? He didn't ask to be a celebrity engine.
I think this was something we brought up in the
live stream.
It wasn't the 4,000.
Oh, it was the big Q&A, wasn't it?
Yeah, but we did look at the possibility of doing a Rick story involving like trespassers or something.
Yeah, because
maybe that could be where Dave mentors him a bit.
I think it's going to be more the fact that engines like Goose will keep telling me he's not a real engine. You know, he's a replica. He's not real. He's not actually, you know, he's a pretend engine. He's a vanity project.
Goose the armchair.
Pretty much. I like Goose as an antagonist. It's kind of funny because you can sort of put a funny spin on it. It's like, yeah, but you're not real. Blah, blah, blah. I literally love how I've just literally coasted all the way along this bit.
Coast
to coast.
So, okay, someone's asked, so would Dave and Hannah be his parent figures? I don't think that's quite it.
That's not quite the intention I'm going for. Although I do love the idea of Hannah saying, can we keep him? No, I don't really like the idea of engines adopting other engines, especially when said engine is about twice as big as you. I think that wouldn't go well in an argument if Hannah tries to ground him, would it?
You know, like Harry Potter, where like dad was like an actual, just a normal person.
what?
Fucking big. That would be what it is.
And then it's a bit like.
Yeah, but the more important question there is Andy, is how did a normal sized guy managed to copulate with a giant woman?
No, you know, the funny thing is, wasn't it said that his dad was actually quite small?
Yes.
In more ways than one. Woo!
This is a bit like that thing of, like, you know, like a kid says, oh, can we keep it? Like, because, like, a dog, but instead of a dog, it's a bear.
You're a bear. It's the great bear.
This bear will not be home. Can we keep it?
Yeah, fucking sure, no.
I want to
fucking no, it's a bear.
You're a bear.
Your uncle's a bear.
Rawr.
Yo. Oh, a pirate's life for me.
Any more interesting questions?
I'm looking. Someone has asked about the 4700 Night Owl. It's a night owl.
I love how the guy there walking, watch him, like, he looks like he shit himself.
Maybe he has to.
No, there's something, like, it looks almost like he's walking by making his legs look. It's weird. Oh, bye.
Okay, bye.
Who left?
Oh, actually, No, the single one went into the box.
Oh. I thought someone had left or something. Oh my god.
It just looked like he just up and disappeared. It was just, oh, bye. which heritage railway would be the first that Rick visits?
That's an interesting one. Because, let's face it, I don't know if he'd visit New Wessex.
No.
I don't think he'd be able to, no. I mean, I'm trying to think of what the problem is. I need to work out what railways would be around in 1981. Mid 1980s, maybe. I think he'd go away on a break. So, what railways were open in 1985 or whatever? I'm not tending him to the Keighley-Worth Valley Railway because he'd literally move one puff forward and be at the end of the line. You can't go to Swanage because it would have only been up to like Harman's Cross by that point.
Someone said the IOWSR would be around in 1985.
Yeah, I'm not sending him to the fucking Isle of Wight. Can you imagine that? Fat H for, like, you know, the islanders, and just like
Rick sitting on the pier, just like, ugh, I don't like this.
H.
Big H. Open wood barrel. Do I really want the wood?
The SVR in 1985.
Maybe the Severn Valley.
Stoffel
maybe. Dover Valley. Fat H.
No.
Will you stop that?
Will you stop that noise, bellowed keeper of porridge?
Keeper of memes. Oh, I'm about to die.
I can certainly say railways he couldn't go through. He couldn't go to even. He couldn't go to Bodmin and Wenford. He can't go to Mangaps, obviously.
Mancaps.
He can't go to the Helston Railway Project. He can't. Helston Railway Project's only like a mile long.
Didcot Railway Centre.
Oh, we're going there.
Can he visit Watercress?
No.
Midhands, yeah, probably.
Midhands. Great Central.
Yes, definitely. He'll definitely fit on the Great Central. We're at the end of the line anyway, so we're going to try and run off, put him in a siding, and then end up. So we'll answer a few more Rick questions then. Anyone got any more requests?
Castleman's.
Yes, the Castleman's he might go to at some point.
Is Rick a posadist? I don't know what that means.
A what?
A posadist.
Andy?
Probably not.
I have no idea. I don't think that's an actual word.
How about the Bluebell Railway? Someone has asked.
Maybe. Well, actually, Bluebell would make sense because it's essentially next door to the DR. So he wouldn't be too far away from home anyway. Now this is going to be interesting.
The Wildy Callum has joined.
Or has he?
Well, he is in the call, so... Yes, he is.
No, he's not.
He's in the call right now. He's there.
Right. So... I'm gonna run him off the track. Run him off here. Run him up here. Run him to the turntable. Prove he can't turn.
2005. I don't know why.
Because someone wanted to be noticed. Like,
yeah. Could Rick pull like 2005 iron ore hoppers? Like, no.
No idea.
No, because this isn't America.
Plus, like, it would take you an hour to place down 2005 iron ore hoppers.
No, it wouldn't, because you just copy, like, you do 10 and then copy and paste that, and then that's 20, and then copy and paste that, and then copy and paste that, you get it.
Yeah, but I think the game would crash before you got to 2005.
I think your game would crash.
It would just be like, too many assets, dump file.
Too many ass.
Alright, I'm gonna have to. Yeah, it looks like it's nearly time for bed anyway. What time is it, actually?
It is 20 to 9.
Yeah, I'll have to think about going to bed shortly.
Oh, cry. Bit to the right. No. Left? No, to the right.
I'm saying, imagine Rick in LMS Crimson Lake.
I've already painted him in Crimson Lake.
Yeah, that was done, wasn't it?
Yeah, I've done that. I've also done him in LMR Apple Green. Well, sorry. Sorry, because he likes it, he has the world's massivest ego. Edward Bull did the reskins.
Oof.
Because if I'd have done that, and he'd have gone, oh, you didn't mention I did the reskins, I'm going to cream.
Oof.
Someone's asked, what would be your opinion on a rebuilt Bullied, such as Eustace, painted into teal with white lining?
What?
Teal.
As in, as like a weird blue colour.
I think so.
Guys?
Yes, mate.
Yeah.
Rick is way too big for the turntable.
Oops.
So I think that's probably the best place for me to leave it then for tonight, because we've done the trip up and down and all that. So I'm going to round off by any more Rick questions quick before I finish.
Not really. No.
What about from you two? If you haven't got one, don't worry. It's fine.
Yeah.
No, I don't.
Unfortunately, now that I've been put on the spot, I can't think of one. So,
Okay. Yeah. Right, in that case then, everyone, we are going to finish up the stream there. Thank you everyone for watching tonight. I know it was a bit impromptu, but, we have done a run up the North York Moors, so, with Rick, so, hope you all have a good evening, and we will see you next time. Goodbye. Say goodbye, everyone.
Goodbye.
Bye.